essential proposals that are crucial to rebuilding Arizona. First, we must prevent financial crisis by enacting a structural budget reform. We must reform the rainy day fund by doubling the maximum size of the funds and to constitutionally restrict its use with a pre-designed formula that makes sense. We can no longer rob the state of the savings to fund programs that are not essential to our way of life. Just as important is using our money appropriately. It is imperative that we commit ourselves to a fair and honest revenue estimation process. We will end the current fiscal year not with an 8% revenue growth, which had been projected, but with a 12% decline in revenue. Such budgeting processes must be fair, and it can no longer be used as a weapon to stall the appropriation process. Secondly, we must stop adding or creating programs that we cannot pay for. I have proposed that we send to the voters a measure to approve the Voter Protection Act by allowing updates to the program that impact general fund budgets. My third proposal reflects the reality that the budget we have inherited will almost certainly require further spending cuts. No one is more acutely aware than I of the depth and the pain of those budget cuts. These reactions and reductions have real impacts on real people and on real families. And it is an outrage that poor planning and funny math has created false hope. I have directed my cabinet to spend the necessary hours and days with their budget staff and their senior administrators to evaluate the impacts of possible cuts in 5% increments up to 20% increments. By 2010, we must arrive at an accumulated cuts and other program changes that reduces the general fund obligation by $1 billion. I know how difficult this task will be, but make no mistake, I made it very clear last week to the legislature a budget without further reduction will not receive my signature. My fourth proposal is to reform and modernize our state tax structure. We cannot have a tax structure that holds back job creation. We need a tax structure that promotes job growth and sustainability, as well as revenue sustainability. To this end, I am calling for a tax reduction that will begin in 2012 and progressively build a more friendly tax code that attracts investment capital and will help create high jobs and high wages, sustainable jobs and wages.